Good evening. Welcome to South Asia Newsline. I'm Yeshi Chansom. Here are the top stories we are tracking for you on Tuesday, the 9th of February. India's Interior Minister says monitoring situation in Uttarakhand glacier tragedy, rescue operations continue. India-Afghanistan holds summit-level talks, sign pact for construction of Shahtur Dam. And Dahal Nepal faction appeals participation in mass gathering against parliament dissolution. And now for all the details. India's Interior Minister Amit Shah said on Tuesday that the centre government was monitoring the situation round the clock in Uttarakhand state glacier burst tragedy as he apprised the parliament about the ongoing rescue operations. The death toll in the incident had rose to at least 30 till the last reports came in.
The death toll in a glacier avalanche in India's northern Uttarakhand state rose to at least 30 as rescue operations continued on Tuesday. Over 170 people were still remain missing after part of a remote Himalayan glacier broke away on Sunday, sweeping away bridges, breaking dams and sending a torrent of water, rocks and construction debris down a mountain valley. Rescue squads have been focused on drilling their way through a 1.5 miles long tunnel at the site to trace the missing. Members of the Indian Parliament paid tributes to the victims on Tuesday, and Interior Minister Amit Shah said the central and state government agencies were monitoring the situation round the clock and providing all possible assistance.
Mananiya Pradhan Mantri Ji swayam sthiti par gehri nigah rakhe hue hain. Gruh Mantralay ke dono control room dwara sthiti par 2400 ghante nazar rakhi ja rahi hai aur rajya ko har sambhav sahayata muhayya karai ja rahi hai.
Authorities on Tuesday began using thermal imagery to trace the missing people, most of whom were working on two projects. Part of the many, the government has been building deep in the mountains of Uttarakhand as part of a development push. Experts said it had snowed heavily last week in the Nanda Devi area, and it was possible that some of the snow had started melting and may have led to an avalanche.
The special cell of police in Indian capital New Delhi on Tuesday arrested Punjabi actor Deep Sidhu, accused of leading a group of farmers who clashed with police and stormed the historic Red Fort last month during the worst day of violence in months of protest against new agriculture reforms. When India celebrated its Republic Day with a military parade on January 26, farmers organized a tractor rally that turned violent as some protesters deviated from the route and broke into the Red Fort complex. One person died and hundreds were injured. Police did not give details of charges against Sidhu but said would interrogate him for his role. Disassociating themselves from the violence, farmer leaders had earlier accused Sidhu had not been a part of their protest and had infiltrated their tractor procession on January 26.
ये जो 26 तारीख को लाल किले और दिल्ली के अन्य भागों पर जिस तरह से हिंसा और उपद्रव संगठित हुआ था उसमें ये दीप सिद्धू नामक का शख्स प्रमुख भूमिका निभाया था. इसकी तस्वीरें पब्लिक डोमेन में है, आप सबने देखा है. इस आरोपी दीप सिद्धू के ऊपर 1 लाख रुपया का इनाम भी घोषणा किया गया था. इस आरोपी दीप सिद्धू को दिल्ली पुलिस की स्पेशल सेल की टीम ने गिरफ्तार कर लिया है. आगे की तफ्तीश जारी है.
India and Afghanistan signed an agreement on a new dam Shahtur to supply drinking water to Kabul during a virtual meeting between Prime Minister Narendra Modi and Afghan President Ashraf Ghani on Tuesday, signaling New Delhi's continuing commitment to the war-torn country.
Indian Prime Minister Narendra Modi held summit-level talks with Afghanistan's President Ashraf Ghani through video conferencing on Tuesday and assured India's full assistance to the conflict-ridden country. Both the countries signed the agreement on Shahtur Dam, which would provide clean drinking water to 2 million citizens of Kabul and will also be used for irrigation. The MOU was signed by India's Foreign Minister S. Jaishankar and his Afghan counterpart Hanif Atmar. The Shahtur Dam is to be constructed on the Kabul River Basin, one of the 5 river basins of Afghanistan. New Delhi has also committed Kabul to take up $80 million worth of projects.
कि आज हम काबुल में जिस सहतूत बांध के निर्माण पर समझौता कर रहे हैं उसकी नींव सिर्फ ईंटों और मोर्टार पर नहीं बनेगी बल्कि भारत अफगान दोस्ती की ताकत पर टिकी होगी।
Meanwhile, thanking India for the gift of water through Shatu Dam and 500,000 doses of the COVID-19 vaccine. Ghani said India's development assistance to Afghanistan is iconically marked on our landscape.
Your decision to provide us with 500,000 doses of the vaccine at this critical time when Indians themselves are looking for every single vaccine could not be a greater gift.
India started exporting coronavirus shots to its neighbors under a grant assistance program dubbed Vaccine Maitri or Vaccine Friendship as New Delhi looks to bolster its vaccine diplomacy.
As the level of violence in Afghanistan remains high and intra-Afghan talks in Doha have been stalled, Chief of United States Central Command General Kenneth McKenzie has said the U.S. is reviewing Taliban actions and the peace agreement. The commander of the United States Central Command, General Kenneth McKenzie, on Monday said the level of violence in Afghanistan remains too high and that the U.S. is reviewing the Taliban actions as well as the peace agreement to find a way forward in the near future. Participating in an online conversation hosted by the Middle East Institute on Monday, he accused the Taliban of continuing to resort to extreme violence, targeted killings and frequent attacks on the Afghan forces. He underlined the imperative of a conditions-based approach to the withdrawal of American troops from Afghanistan.
Continue to resort to extreme violence with targeted killings across the country and frequent attacks on the ANSDF Afghan forces. And while they have mostly avoided attacking U.S. and coalition units, the level of violence is just simply too high. And so that's an action that we look at. We continue to watch Taliban actions, and I know that the administration is taking a close look at the way forward.
Earlier, Republican U.S. Senator Lindsey Graham, in an interview with CBS, said that the American troops will not leave Afghanistan in May, supporting the Biden administration's stance on Afghanistan and its bid to review the U.S.-Taliban agreement. Pentagon announced in late January that it was reviewing the Doha deal on Afghanistan signed in February of last year. The deal requires the U.S. to withdraw all forces from Afghanistan within 14 months in exchange for counterterrorism assurances from the Taliban. However, U.S. officials have said the Taliban have failed to split from terrorist group Al-Qaeda as required by the agreement. The intra-Afghan talks in Qatar have been stalled as violence in Afghanistan escalates.
In news from Pakistan, Pakistan People's Party Chairman Bilawal Bhutto Zardari has urged the establishment to stay away from politics and the upcoming Senate polls. This comes at a time when Pakistan Democratic Movement Alliance, which also includes Bilawal's party, is contesting the Senate elections jointly against Prime Minister Imran Khan's PTI.
Chairperson of PPP, the Pakistan People's Party, Bilawal Bhutto Zardari, has demanded that the establishment stay away from Senate polls and politics, warning that if the Senate elections were made controversial, it would affect the entire country. Addressing a press conference in Karachi, Bilawal on Monday said his PPP wanted that not only should the establishment not take part in Senate elections, but it should have no political role, adding that if they have political office, it should be closed. Bilawal said he believed that the ruling PTI was still able to function only because it has the establishment support.
Wo saaf aur shaffaf elections, ghair mutanaza elections nahi chahte hain. Agar wo waqai chahte the to bahut hi time tha. To 3 saal se hukumat mein hain. Bahut hi time tha ki wo comprehensive electoral reforms और उसके साथ साथ जो कानून साजी को ज़रूरत होता जो आईन में तरमीम का ज़रूरत होता उस पर वो बात और काम भी कर सकते थे।
This comes at a time when PDM, the Pakistan Democratic Movement, an alliance of 11 opposition parties, including Bilawal's PPP, has announced that all its allied parties will contest jointly in the Senate elections.
More news from Pakistan. Amid rising inflation, the Pakistan government has increased fuel prices substantially this month. Residents in Karachi city have expressed anguish over the move, blaming Prime Minister Imran Khan-led government's ill-planned policies for the ongoing economic crisis.
Residents in Pakistan's Karachi city who are already irked by the rising inflation in the country have expressed anguish over a sharp hike in fuel prices earlier this month. They said the step has shaken the budget of the middle class and paralyzed the already burdened poor people working hard to earn even square meal a day. Pakistani authorities on February 1 increased the price of petrol and diesel by up to 2.70 and 2.88 rupees per litre. Residents complained that with the hike in petrol prices, a direct impact would be again witnessed on prices of essential commodities as they are transported via road.
कहते हैं कि पहले ही इतनी महंगाई हो गई है कि लोग जो हैं वो आटे दाल से और अपने बच्चों की पढ़ाई से और अब जो है महंगाई हो रही है फीस देने से लोग कासर हैं, बच्चे स्कूल नहीं जा रहे, घरों में गैस नहीं आ रही, बिजली की मुश्किल है, उसके ऊपर गवर्नमेंट ने एक और बम फेंक दिया कि हमें पेट्रोल की महंगाई दे रही है। ये कौन सा तोहफा दे रही है गवर्नमेंट हमें? ये किस जुर्म की सजा मिल रही है हमें? क्या इसलिए कि हम तब्दीली चाहते थे? ये क्या तब्दीली हो रही है?
और यार ये गवर्नमेंट जो है ना, ये इसके पास प्लानर कोई नहीं है, ये सब झूठ का पलंदा है। और ये अब ये पेट्रोल महंगा, वो हर चीज़ बढ़ेगी और बिजली भी बढ़ेगी, और फिर कहेंगे बिजली के जो पिछले महीने के बिल बढ़ते हैं वो कहते हैं जी हमारा फ्यूल महंगा था इसलिए हुआ।
Pakistan's economy has witnessed a steady decline since 2018 when Prime Minister Imran Khan's government came into power. While the government is failing to raise revenue, the country continues to take out loans to be able to cover repayments of past borrowing, ultimately making the citizens suffer.
Moving on to news from Nepal. Leaders of ruling NCP Nepal Communist Party Pushpa Kamal Dahal and Madhav Kumar Nepal have appealed people to participate in their mass rally on Wednesday, being organized in central Kathmandu to counter caretaker Prime Minister KP Sharma Oli's February 5 show of strength. A similar gathering was organized by NCP's Oli faction in Kathmandu last week, which was in response to Dahal Nepal faction's protest programs in the recent days against Oli's move of dissolving the lower house of the parliament in December. Oli says he dissolved the parliament citing a lack of cooperation from other NCP leaders. Meanwhile, the decision of dissolution of parliament is also being challenged in the Supreme Court. Authorities in Dachigam National Park in India's Jammu and Kashmir have made special arrangements to keep the endangered hangul, a rare species of red deer, well-fed this winter. Every year, as winter tightens its grip over the northernmost region, the Kashmiri stag has a hard time looking for food amid snow and sub-zero temperatures.
Authorities of the Jammu and Kashmir Wildlife Department in India have made arrangements for food for the endangered Kashmiri stag, locally known as hangul, in the Dachigam National Park. With the valley receiving a significantly increased amount of snowfall this year, it has been very difficult for the hangul to get proper food in the upper reaches. The hangul is the only surviving subspecies in the Indian subcontinent of the red deer family native to Europe.
This year, lower area mein iski movement bahut zyada hai hangul ki. Baaki saalon ke mukable mein is saal ज़्यादा मूवमेंट इनकी है, इसलिए हम इनको ये ग्रीन लीव्स वगैरह जो हैं और ये सब्ज़ी हमें अलर्ट रहना पड़ता है। नीचे गेट से यहाँ तक हमको 4 किलोमीटर चल के कंधे पे सब्जी लेके आके यहाँ पे इनको डालनी पड़ती है।
Known for its giant antlers bearing 11 to 16 points, the hangul has been hunted for centuries and its habitat has been destroyed, leading to its plunging population. Once found in high altitude regions of northern India, the Kashmiri stag is now confined to only Dachigam National Park in Kashmir.
Well, that's all we have for you from South Asia this evening. Now our viewers can watch the show on southasianewsline.com. You can also visit us on facebook.com/isasianewsline and follow us on Twitter at isasianewsline. That's all in tonight's edition. We will see you same time tomorrow. Good night.